Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, came into the National Hockey League in 1967, same time as Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Mario Lemieux came into Pittsburgh in 1984. The franchise he owns is 45 seasons old. These two teams are neighbors. They're not friends. The Commonwealth Cold War, Philadelphia versus Pittsburgh. When the Flyers and Penguins face off, intrastate relations get icy. Both teams are skilled.
There it is, number 50 for Evgeny Malkin.
Both teams are tough, but which team will prevail in this seven-game series and move closer to the ultimate goal, a Stanley Cup championship? Game one, the Battle of Pennsylvania next. Consol Energy Center in Pittsburgh, scene of sports, concerts, graduations, and now some war games, best of seven. Welcome to the Stanley Cup playoffs, presented by GEICO. Good evening, everyone. I'm Mike Emmerich. Welcome to our unprecedented coverage of the Stanley Cup playoffs on the NBC family. We are going to give you a lot of games. We don't know the exact total. All we know is it's going to be all of them. It is a wonderful time of the year for all of us. We hope it is for you, too. This series here is the one that's been most talked about of the eight that we begin with in our coverage. Philadelphia and Pittsburgh. Two franchises that have definite cultures. They have fan bases that love their teams passionately. They believe in coming to work with a lunch pail, and they believe in showing it out there and leaving it there. All of that makes this a wonderful setup for us and Pierre McGuire, who's inside the glass. Pierre, Pittsburgh is picked by many to win the Stanley Cup. Why is that?
Well, everybody looks at their skill and they're overwhelmed by it, as they should be, Doc, because it's one-on-one, it's team, and it's highlight reel variety. Sidney Crosby working on the New York Islanders, the most lethal backhand in the National Hockey League. Evgeny Malkin, if you don't play the man and you play the puck, he'll make you look silly. And then James Neal coming down either the right wing or the left wing. He can beat you with any kind of shot, a fantastic array of firepower on the Pittsburgh Penguins side, Doc, and if you don't play the man and you choose to play the puck, you'll look bad.
What does Philadelphia bring in response?
Well, they've got a little skill of their own, starting with Claude Drew, but they also have a smash mouth component that's so critical for them. Here's a little highlight of Claude Giroux's handiwork. Skillful, finesseful, and all kinds of speed. How about this, though? Scotty Hartnell in the slot, the dirty area. Dion Phaneuf, I don't like you, I'm going with it. And then Maxime Talbot, the former Penguin, he gets to the dirty area. They hit, they forecheck, they play with passion. The Philadelphia Flyers are full value, and they will be tough on the Penguins.
Can you hear the 18,000 in the background? You'll hear from the players, you'll hear from this crowd, you'll hear the anthem. You'll see if the forecasts of major penalties go up in smoke. Act one of an unscripted morality play in a moment. Sidney Crosby, captain of the Pittsburgh Penguins, the team with the most goals this past season. His number 87 is worn by more fans in Western Pennsylvania than any other. He faces Scott Hartnell and the Philadelphia Flyers. Scott had 37 goals, most for the team that was most penalized but most loved in Eastern Pennsylvania. The Stars, the anthem, the start of the game in a moment. To the ice, Pierre McGuire and Sidney Crosby.
Thank you, Doc. What was Dan Biles' message before you came out here?
Just do the same things we've preached all year. You know, we've been doing a lot of good things throughout the year, and this is when it's going to show. So just let the hard work that we had all year pay off in big games like this.
Go out and have some fun in this series, Sid.
Okay, thank you.
This will be Sidney Crosby's first game in the playoffs at Consol Energy Center, injured at this time last year, and the same for Evgeny Malkin. For Ilya Brizgalov, the Flyers goalie, the first start he has ever made inside this arena, too. Mandated at the end of World War II, long before these franchises existed, the performance of an anthem. That's next, and here first the voice of PA announcer Ryan Mill.
Please rise, remove your hats, and direct your attention to the Zamboni Gate, and welcome the United States Marine Corps Color Guard presenting our nation's colors. And please welcome back Mr. Jeff Jimerson with the singing of the Star Spangled Banner.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn? early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, came through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Passionate yet respectful, Jeff Jimerson and the anthem. Starting goalies presented by Honda Pilot. The first playoff start for Ilya Bryzgalov. Winning streaks this year of 6-7 and a tremendous March. 70th straight playoff start for Marc-Andre Fleury. Winning streaks of 9-10. A marvelous season for him. Zdeněk Pakalik, Brooks Orpik, Jordan Staal, Matt Cook, and Tyler Kennedy start for Pittsburgh. Scott Hartnell, Claude Giroux, Jaromir Jagr, the big productive line. Matt Carl and Kimmo Tiiminen on defense. Beyond this, check out the faces of these guys as they begin the playoffs. And we'll listen to the crowd just to see if there's a build-up here before the opening draw. The draw won by Philadelphia. They try for Hartnell and get McCauley. There's one of the first hits. Not a big boomer yet, just a rub out by Hartnell on McCauley. Jaromir Jagr, they remember, played in Pittsburgh. That's why the booing. It's pushed on goal. And Marc-Andre Fleury made that first stop. Chipped along near Jagr. Went away from Matt Cook. Kept alive by Tiiminen, bunted along, and a swing and a miss there, and a tough play by Giroux, so Tyler Kennedy can bring it on back. Kennedy holds to the deep slot and shoots one, and that's blocked away by Bryzgalov. Now Giroux's turn. Down the ice for the first touch-up and stop of the game.
Well, Doc, icing by Philadelphia. We're a little less than 45 seconds in. That line has to stay out. Jaromir Jagr, Claude Giroux, Matty Carl also with Kimmo Tiiminen and Scotty Hartnell. Hartnell's taking his time right now to buy some time for that man, Jagr. You see how slow Jagr is? And the Penguins bench is screaming. They want to drop the puck.
Jagr, 40 years of age. Five times the NHL scoring champion, all with Pittsburgh. Kunitz close quarters. Rocked a bit there by Hartnell. It's squibbed around behind and Giroux has to play. Neal first, Malkin second on him. This one slithers back down. Will it be icing? No. It's on Marc-Andre Fleury. He plays it ahead. Meanwhile, the Flyers get the change they wanted. This is back down for Grossman. Bumped into there by Kunitz. Tipped off of Max Talbot and poked right back along, but it must be still played at center and eventually it comes to Brooks Orpik. Big hitter for the Penguins, flipped one on fast. Braden Coburn. Grossman took the hit from Neal, reversed it onto Coburn. Intercepted along by Crosby and Couturier. Up for grabs and thrown by Neal. That one squibbed wide. It is set back up for McCauley. Lets a shot go. That's really a deflection attempt for Steve Sullivan, but it can be controlled and started back out again. Zach Rinaldo, good shoulder bump there with Pascal Dupuis. The 45-year-old chant of Let's Go Pens here in Pittsburgh. The last 2 years at Consol Energy Center and the first 43 across the street at what was first known as Civic Arena. Pascal Dupuis has been involved in his first collision. This is played ahead to him, and he's pressed off there by Andreas Lilja. Dupuis ended the season with a point in 17 straight games, the longest string that anyone had this year. Fleury reversed it along. Outlet it ahead for Craig Adams. Adams dealt it across, and a shot turned aside by Briscola from the stick of Aaron Asham. Joe Vitale with that one, poked it around behind. Can be played by Adams. Laid to the back for Lovejoy. Handed on across again for a carom shot off the board. Lovejoy decided the better pinching, but it came to him for the drive. That is deflected away, and Asham set it up again. Another shot, blocked in front, going for it is Vitale. And Vitale laid it on back again for Lovejoy. Through Vitale, around the roulette wheel, Engelin playing in his first Stanley Cup game, number 5 for Pittsburgh. Cracked there. It is cleared all the way back down, and there will be an icing. Let's head down to Pierre. Reebok Flex inside the glass.
Well, it's electric right now. Part of the game plan for the Pittsburgh Penguins, they know Nicklas Grossman's not 100%. You get pucks in deep and you body slam them. You see the first one by Kunitz. The entire Pittsburgh Penguin bench screaming at James Neal, put him in. He puts him in. That's going to be one of the things to watch for Philadelphia. Can Grossman withstand the physical pounding? They need him to.
That one turned aside by Brizgalov. Puck sent onto the back to Paul Martin. Spun it around, and Kunitz a shot, and that deflected up high, and it popped out of play. The Flyer goalkeeper, ever alert. In the course of March, he was as good as there was. He had 4 shutouts in a short stretch. There have been times this year that have not been good for him. At the other end, Marc-Andre Fleury has had mostly good times all year. A checkered year, but all of that is erased since I have a grasp of the obvious, because it's opening night and the records are 0-0. All the hit posts, everything else, it all starts anew. With Sidney Crosby burrowing in front, can't pull the trigger on the shot. Coburn able to get away and flick it along, but it's played by Sullivan for Dupuis. Cutting by Crosby, dealt to the back again. Chris Letang fires one, and that one deflected around in front. Another shot, they score!
Sidney Crosby to keep the play alive against Braden Coburn. The quick release by Chris Letang. A little rebound situation off of Grossman, and Crosby wins a race against Coburn. Off of Grossman. Watch Crosby out-muscle Coburn at the point of attack. Up and over Brizgalov. 1-0 Pittsburgh. All hard work, all effort. Win the battle. Spin off. Get to the net. Stick of the ice pitch.
Mandated by the Chamber of Commerce, the first goal of this series. Chamber of Commerce of Pittsburgh. Crosby and Malkin have tremendous records against the Flyers in the playoffs. Better than a point a game, close to a point and a half. The Flyers are used to 1-0 deficits. Cook with a shot that's blocked down, and Cook able to play it along. They have been behind 1-0 and come back to win 20 games. Nobody in the league did that well. Marc-Andre Fleury, and then McCulloch chased off. The heavy hit came from Hartnell, and this goes back down for Kimmo Tiimonen. 4-time Finnish Olympian taps it around behind, and back up the boards it comes to be battled for there by Hartnell. Taken on by Danny Briere, who is run into by Kennedy. A lot of collisions. Everyone following through on checks. Undoubtedly, the coaches have said, hit him. He doesn't like it. Who does?
Too many men on the ice, Philadelphia, right now. You got a problem. Philadelphia, too many men on the ice, and Hartnell jousting with Orpik. But that all started because of an extended shift. You see the line change coming up. Kimmo Tiimonen and Matt Cook joust right in front of where I'm standing. Jordan Staal jumps in. And it eventually leads to, are they going to wave it off? They're not going to call too many men on the ice. They're telling them not to say anything to the officials. They just want to know why it wasn't too many men. Well,
so it's going to remain at full strength.
Yeah. The fans don't like it either right now.
Well, you were hearing what you were hearing down there, Pierre. That was probably a lot of Penguins calling it. And when the officials are making a signal, sometimes it's because there is no signal other than, you know, maybe a circular motion from one of the linesmen with the index finger that there are too many men. This is a cancellation here, and then it is deflected high. Crosby's first of these playoffs from Dupuis and Letang. Twisted by Grossman. Max Talbot to get it there. He's roughed out as it's played to center off Martin and across to Letang. In terms of wins and losses, the Penguins did better with Sidney Crosby out of the lineup than they did without Chris Letang. He was so important to their defense, their power play, and everything else that the numbers were positive for both being away from the team because Pittsburgh won so many games. But it was more so for Letang than Crosby even. Back down this comes to be rolled along by Bourbon. Can be taken on by Wayne Simmons. Career high here for him. Simmons tried to center and could not. Briere got there. Threw one around behind that is off Engelin and battled for it. Simmons working the front with some physical pressure as this comes to the back and is skipped on by Lilja. Can be read by the Penguins with 6 minutes having been played here in the first period and the shots at 5-1, Pittsburgh. Joe Vitale tries to work in, but it is an icing touch-up.
Doc, one of the hardest things about playing against Sidney Crosby in a matchup, he doesn't quit on plays. He rolled off of Braden Coburn, established body position, and won the race for the loose puck. And then you see Pascal Dupuis come over to keep Coburn and Grossman away from him. But when you're playing against Crosby, like a lot of stars, especially at this time of the year, if you give them 1 inch that they can beat you to the net, you're in trouble.
Led to the back for a shot by Thiemann and save. Rebound! And that one jabbed wide. A try there by Eric Wellwood. Swung back along away from Reed. Wellwood after that one. Vitale after him. Led on now to Craig Adams. Ladled across with a punch back down. Ben Lovejoy just back from injury. Number 6 in the dark uniform. A knee surgery that he had and he missed 6 games. There was a time when Mario Lemieux was playing that if players had a knee injury and it required surgery, arthroscopic hadn't been developed, it was 4 to 6 weeks. Puck played on back to center. I'm curious what the chattering is down there, Pierre, only because we saw some on April the 1st.
Very simple, Doc. Nothing between the benches. Nothing on the ice right now. I think guys are just clued into what they're trying to do to maintain their game plans.
Little back pass by Crosby is thrown back on by Reed. Played on across now to Jaromir Jagr, who is able to filter it back in and go after it. 12th all-time scoring leader in the history of the NHL is Jagr. Much of those points accumulated here in Pittsburgh. Let it head now for Crosby. Rolled off one check and punched it back in. The door is open. He steps in. A shift change for his team. Giroux gets the return pass. Spiked away just beyond the reach of Jagr. Bourbon pushed it in front. Letang with a nice stiff backhand pass. That can be carried on by Jordan Staal. Flyers hurry to get back. Staal fed it through.
Neither can Jagr, and Tyler Kennedy takes that nifty feed from Jordan Staal from the back end of the forehand to the back of the net.
Pierre, at the top, you mentioned the speed and how quickly Pittsburgh can transition. We've seen that example and an earlier one, the reach by Crosby. There is a timeout. The Flyers are gathered around Peter Laviolette.
Right now, they're losing races, and they're trying to over-muscle situations. But it all starts with the Penguins because of real good defense. Down low, hard on the puck by Christopher Letang. He has great body position on Hartnell, creating a foot race situation. And you can see Jagr just can't keep up. The hard pass, Jagr wants to to get back. He's got the right idea, but it's a great transition by the Penguins.
Kennedy from Stahl at 7:49. The secondary assist, Chris Letang, who has assisted on both of the goals here at the start. Five of the Penguins in the lineup tonight are getting their first taste of Stanley Cup action. Seven of the Flyers. In a year in which 20% of the Flyers' goals, or maybe slightly more than that, were scored by rookies. That largely caused by injury. Both teams had them. Crosby missed such a long time. And Chris Pronger, the bulwark of the Flyers' defense, is now missing his 60th in a row tonight. Banged ahead now for control by Letang. Pushed it out to center. Guided across to Neal. Neal with a shot, and that blocked wide. Neal digging around behind. 40 goals for Neal, fourth in the entire league this year in the regular season. Collared by Letang and spun ahead to Kunitz. Flyers change. That one slowed down by Matt Carl and collared by Brizgalov. In the first 8 minutes, the Penguins have scored twice. Sidney Crosby with the reach. Tyler Kennedy with the shot. A man named Bernard Marcel Perron was the last Flyers goalkeeper to author a Stanley Cup victory, 1975. The Flyers are wearing the same design and color of jersey that they wore in that year. Letang with a shot, and that went wide of Brizgalov and the cage. Battled for there and pushed on with the help of Sullivan. Cut off by Carl and handed back on for Danny Briere. Briere rattled it back in, and Fleury was not able to really pull around the post to get back to it, so it came for Tiemann. Then along for Shen. Shen fed, Tiemann lifted, and that one blocked around in front and then controlled behind, but then just that quickly lost. What a good check for the Flyers off of Paul Martin of Pittsburgh's defense, but carried right back on by Crosby. It is Martin escaping and starting back in. Chip one across, hoping for Dupuis, but taken on by the Flyers, and laid a hit for Voracek, and a shot is deflected wide. That was Jágr, I beg your pardon, who got that breakaway. Led across now for the crank right back in. And punched around behind. A huge stop made on Jágr. It's like 1.5 saves to fans here. And as is the booing in Philadelphia, Crosby, it's roster envy. They would have liked him to have picked them. That's all. Drop back for a shot by Kennedy. That is held by Brizgalov. Shots, 10 by Pittsburgh, 2 goals by them. Kia Coaches Interview, Pierre McGuire with Penguins coach Dan Bylsma.
Is it more about physical or skill for you guys right now?
Well, we want it to be a long series and play in the offensive zone, and we got to keep getting in that offensive zone and playing there, whether it's physicality or just zone times. We got to keep getting there, and we have been.
Looks like there's a target on Nicholas Grossman's back, fair to say?
I don't think there's just one on his. I think we're trying to get after their defense, and we know we got to put pucks behind him. It's not just for this 60 minutes. We're investing for the whole series.
Thanks, Dan.
Thank you.
It is a time of year, Dan Bylsma said today, when coaches as well as players have a faster resting heart rate. It's just constant. At times it's uncomfortable. But he said, you get comfortable with the discomfort of it. In other words, nerves are normal. This is Voracek this time, and played on a long where Ronaldo is able to jam it back in. A twist by Voracek, and that was met by an emphatic hit that came from Engeling. Steve Sullivan sees that one come off his stick and out to center ice. There are some very large people out here. Steve Sullivan is not one of them. You can be an NHLer if you are under 5'7". Puck came on across for a shot. Oh, and a headhunter that got the glass.
Doc, that almost blew his guy off. I don't think he was expecting that kind of velocity.
Bounced around in front and laid on across now for the pass that's free at neutral ice and then could not be stopped by Letang. So Malkin takes it. Intercepted and carried on by Max Talbot. Paul Martin, been a Minnesota native. Played it along to Letang and helped back up the boards off of Neal's stick. Pretty good flow to Pittsburgh's game here as they enter again, and it's Malkin. Sashays by and poked one. That was blocked away. And a good closure with the pad by Rizgalov. And that one ricocheted off Letang. Max Talbot tried to get as far as center. No luck. Down to the last 8 1/4 of the first, and the crowd responding again to what they have seen. For no particular reason, just recognizing the excellence that the home team has given them so far. They also remember a game in Philadelphia where their team led 2-0 and lost in overtime. This one is laid around in front, and a shot by Briere is stopped and paddled away by Fleury. More hits. Matt Cook took a tumble. Bordone tried to play it further. Kick back near Kennedy. Outlets it on ahead, and Matt Cook can walk it off. 22 minor penalties, no majors this year for Matt Cook. And a total change in his approach to the game. Laid ahead now by Briere, and that ladled down by Simmons. Stopped by Fleury and foisted behind for McCollum. And Fleury just now getting back up.
Simmons got him from behind. Fans didn't like that. Into the Penguins bench.
Must have been pretty clever to not draw a penalty. Rattled right back in, and this one kicked right on goal and stuck to the back of the cage for a halt to the action.
And Doc, he is a clever player. There isn't a team in the league that wouldn't want Wayne Simmons on it. He's smart, he's pugnacious, he's quick, and he understands his role. And you can see him, I don't mean to hit him, but I do. He knew exactly what he was doing, and the referees let him play on. And you know what? There's nothing wrong. If they're going to call it the same way for both teams, then play on. If they're going to change halfway through the course of the game, then it's a problem.
We've seen no evidence of that so far.
Correct.
It is a penalty-free first thus far. Puck laid to the back, and it's Carl throwing one in front that's blocked off and then chipped on and played out by Craig Adams. Crosby was the one who fed it to him, and Crosby's still in the zone, but they can't generate any kind of offense there, so it's loved on back now. Pulled to the outside by Giroux and flung wide of the glove hand of Fleury. Boy, just a great collision up the boards. Thrown in front, and that one ricocheted through the crease wide and can be shuffled by Crosby on out to center. He's met there and given a pretty good hit, and then an extra shot by Hartman.
Took a hit to make a play, Doc. Way off top by Sidney Crosby. Take the hit, make a play.
And when you wear the C, everyone notices on both benches what you have done. In particular, when you lead by example. Many stories back through history of that. Off the outside of the cage, dug out there by Talbot. Talbot sent one in front, a shot by Couturier would not go. And it's Asham to start back the other way for the Penguins. Dropped it on now for Joe Vitale. Drew one across, and the shot skittered wide. The try by Jordan Staal. Bumped along by Lovejoy, tries to get it free to Staal, and it's guided along further. Boy, every time Grossman has the puck, he is hit, this time by Staal.
Oh, they know he's not 100%. They're going to lean on him big time. You hear what Danny Bosma said, Doc.
It appears we will have peace for now. 12 shots to 6 Penguins. 2-0. This is our Audi Achievement player, Evgeny Malkin. Why? Look at this. Second in the league in goals. Steven Stamkos had 60. Third in assists. First in points. He has had lots of trophies. He has not had the Hart Trophy by some of the people from this distance, 7 floors up, decide that. Or the Pearson Trophy, decided by the players. Both are MVPs. Offside is called against the Flyers.
Rolling puck for Braden Culver, and he couldn't keep it in, and a good job by Brian Murphy making the call on the offside. You see the puck roll on Culver at number 5. Watch it just roll over a stick at the last second, and that requires pretty quick eye and whistle coordination by Brian Murphy, the linesman.
Paul Martin throws that one back off, and it careened further for the play of Grossman. Neal and Malkin are out there together. Paul Martin comes over for the closure. Drop back to Letang.
Peter Laviolette wants to have these guys on the ice as much as he can, especially Couturier against Malkin, Kunitz, and Neal.
Matt Reed blocked wide and out of play.
And every team has a chance to win, Doc. It's unbelievable, the parity. These races and these playoff battles are going to be immense.
Play stopped.
Hand pass.
On a hand pass. You know, we're going to be enjoying our off nights. We don't get as many of them as maybe a lot of people that work around the league or have jobs to go to and come home where they can watch every game every night. But on the nights we're not working, Pierre, we're going to be watching too.
Oh, yes.
So much fun. And the first round is always helter-skelter for the reason that you mentioned. You can make a case for anybody coming out of these matchups that we have. All best of seven. One time best of five until 1987. We've been going best of seven in all rounds since then. Tipped on back for the play to be made back out for Yager. Across to Giroux. Giroux with lots of moves. That one trickled on through, though, for McCulloch to reverse back up. Flyers in the midst of a change, so the Penguins, uncontested, are able to gain the line. Dropped back by Stahl. Cook with a shot that's blocked away by Bourdon. Conrad Bourdon able to feel a pass that kicked back up now for the play back in by Briere to the bench for an obedient change for 20 to go in the first.
Some different line combinations right now. Simmons, Wellwood, and Chen. We haven't seen that yet in this game for Philadelphia.
Peter Laviolette probing, trying to come up with something that will generate more. Maybe it's right here, a little feed in front, and that was slidingly blocked away by McCulloch and led back on for Sullivan to chip it to center ice. Fleury able to direct it across. Brooks Orpik with it there. Boston College product saw this one played on ahead. Moving on in is Crosby, shooting one that was slowed down a bit. And then directed away by Brizgalov, right back near Crosby again.
Doc, they're not going to want Lilly on the ice against Crosby. They got to keep away from that one.
This is Sullivan around behind. Had Crosby in front, could not get it there to him, and Simmons is able to bash it back down, and it will go for an icing. Flyers hurriedly trying to change to not be seen, but they have been spotted.
Crosby comes to the bench smiling because he knows he fanned on it for Andreas Lilly, and not an easy play because of the distribution by Kennedy. And look at the move by Crosby on Lilia. Lilia doesn't have a lot of lateral mobility anymore, Doc. He's not getting any younger. And you can see the speed just backs him off the line. He's very lucky that Crosby fanned on the shot.
Centering pass in front, and that jab to the corner as Malkin is out there now. Malkin with Neal and Kunitz. In a 50-game span, they had 77 goals, these three. Bourdon given a rough ride by Kunitz. Kunitz, the proud player from Ferris State, All-American. They got to the final before losing to Boston College. The Frozen Four will be played here in Pittsburgh next year and the following year in Philadelphia. Tipped across now for the dump back up the boards. Reaching in was Kunitz, but emerging with it is Couturier. One of those seven rookies bounces one in that's near the net and blocked aside by Fleury. Taken by Talbot and stashed on back as far as center. Right idea, but just the timing was not perfect, and it had to be. To the last 2.5 of this first period. Led by Martin off of Ashen. Thrown along by Carl. A weak toss is blocked down by Ashen, sparred for by Vitali, and lifted back along by Voracek. On at center, blocked down, carried back on by Yager. He escapes, and his shot slithered wide. Worked back on now to Ashen. Tried to turn and toss, could not. Controlled in front by Brooks Orpik, and Orpik able to scale one back out. Vitali tried to settle it down, but it's stopped by Adams, and his shot was carefully blocked and neatly done there by Kimmo Tiimonen. Blasted right back in, and Brizgalov watches. Ooh, rubbed out that time was Giroux. Back on his feet, seems okay. Hartnell brings it ahead. As Simmons on that line right now as they're in the midst of a change. Fed back across by Letang. Lots of bouncing bodies, much of it generated by the team in black. Letang fed it across, carried back on by Kennedy, could not get through, and so Briere connects back for his defense to him. Crosby with it, fed on to Cook, could not escape for the shot as Lilium is on him. Rush back on down to Simmons, cross-bodied by Dupuis. Puck escapes to Briere, and he fed it back in, and it's stopped around behind by Fleury. A little head fake there, and then he handed it on to Letang. Dupuis runned out. The puck escapes back down. Will it be icing? No. Canceled out by Sullivan's hustle. Lifted along further by Crosby. Sullivan, a little back pass in front. All fed around. Head in! Dupuis!
Sometimes when you poke the bear, you get in trouble. Crosby keeps his play alive with a creative play to Sullivan, and then Sullivan with some more creativity out front to Pascal Dupuis, who establishes another one race against Nicholas Grossman. 3-0 Pittsburgh. Great coordination by Dupuis, but the creativity by Crosby to get that puck in deep and allow the foot race to ensue for Sullivan. Watch Crosby. Wants the puck, wants it, and then smart. Get it up high. Let Sullivan win a race.
That's a thing of beauty and creativity.
Jostled there, gently bumped into Fleury. Forced along by McCulloch, and it bounced to center. In their dreams, Penguins fans may have seen this 3-0 after one. Now it's reality. Three by the Penguins, none by the Flyers after 20.
If you're Pittsburgh, how sweet does this walk feel?
No hitch, and they're giddy up. They're on fire in that first period, and you're feeling pretty good about yourself heading to the dressing room.
And they should. They just have to worry about not being arrogant, but letting that spill over into entitled, because we've seen Philadelphia come back on any number of occasions.
Welcome to your Demish Report. Liam McHugh, Mike Milbury, Keith Jones. For those following the whole Ilya Bryzgalov soap opera, here is an update right now. Crosby, Kennedy, Dupuis, they're playing the roles of bears. Console Energy Center playing the role of the forest. It's 3-0. One thing we definitely wondered with this series especially was if things would get physical, if they would cross the line physically. How do you think Pittsburgh fared in that regard?
Perfect. Exactly what Dan Bylsma wanted from his team. Good hard work between the whistles. None of the extracurricular stuff. Just get in on the body. Be physical. Be smart. Go after the star players. Malkin tries to run over Giroux. Bourdon rocked by Dupuis. And the key was Grossman. You heard Pierre Maguire talking about it. No question the Penguins know he's not 100%. Two physical plays on him. It rattled him on the first shift. And Crosby finds the loose puck between Grossman's feet, elevates the puck to the back of the net. You have tons of meetings before a playoff game. Unlike a regular season game, you break down every aspect of it as a team. The Penguins were more organized. They were perfect to their game plan, and they deserved to be up 3-0 after that first period.
It sounds almost ridiculous to say, but coming into the postseason, one of the biggest question marks for Pittsburgh was their goaltender, Marc-Andre Fleury. And that's because over his final five games, a 4.08 goals against average, just an 8.56 save percentage. How do you grade his play in the first period?
I thought he was timely and terrific, and I don't think there should have been anywhere near as much questions about Fleury. I mean, he almost set a franchise record for wins in a season, and it was 2-0 here, and he stones Jagr here. That's the first save. Briere will then get a second chance. Remember, 2-0, this is a lead that the Penguins have squandered to Philadelphia in the past. And again, Couturier here in close, not spectacular, but pretty solid saves by a guy who just said, hey, I'm here, I'm ready, this is not going to be an issue, no longer should we be discussing goaltending for Pittsburgh.
Last postseason, when we watched Philadelphia, we played the game Wheel of Goaltenders. It was just a revolving door. So Bryzgalov gives up 3 in the first period. Any shot that he'll be pulled and not brought back to the second period?
no chance that he'll be pulled. He'll be back in to start the second period. It was a circus last year, the carousel of goaltenders, and even the third goal. Although Brizgalov would want to have this one back, there is some flukiness to this puck that finds the back of the net, goes off the butt end of a stick and into the goal. But you'll see him come out to start the second period. If it gets to 5 or 6-0, and then it comes into question whether you pull him, but he will start the second.
He may start, but on the other hand, that won't stop the questions from being raised about Brizgalov, because all the questions about the Flyers have been around the goaltending. Even though Brizgalov finished pretty well, it's been up and down, and everybody was looking at what he would do so far in the first period.
Would you pull him, knowing what he was brought in for?
I wouldn't. I think they have to lean on this guy a little longer, but there's no question the people on that team are going to be unsettled by this. And believe me, tomorrow, top story that you'll see, should this continue this way, will be about Ilya Brizgalov.
The count right now is 3-0. It is in favor of the Pens. The man who broke the ice is none other than Sidney Crosby. Including the regular season, Crosby has 7 goals over his last 10 games. We're back after this.
Welcome back to the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico. Steel City of Pittsburgh. City of Three Rivers. If you're looking from the south, on the left is A, Allegheny. On the right is M, Monongahela, forming the Ohio. That's how I keep them straight. I know that big home runs sometimes go into the Allegheny. Meanwhile, this has started out with a 3-0 deficit for the Flyers, but the Flyers on the attack with their big unit. Down to the ice goes Giroux. It is pulled and settled down and handed across to Brooks Orr. Played back in by Stahl. Gotten by Cook and just fed away from a man all alone named Kennedy. Led back on by Yager. Hartnell with the shove on McCulloch. It squirts loose now for Kennedy. Outlets on for Stahl. Stahl pulls. Sized up there by Grossman, and Grossman is able to take that. So Pittsburgh hammered a lot in the first period. What do you think the Flyers talked about between periods?
Composure, puck control, don't get rattled, and start making hard plays at Marc-André Fleury.
This is finessed by Malkin and can be played around behind by Kunitz and forced on out to Neal. Pretty neat when on one line you have one guy that scored 50 and another guy that scored 40. And when playing with Chris Kunitz, he adds a new dimension to that line in that he hammers people, and Neal has the size to do it and does too. Fired into some traffic. Given back on to Neal. Former Dallas star slipped it on. Malkin tried to pass but fanned on it. And spun by Kunitz but read in front by Couturier. And so Paul Martin. Pulled back on by Simmons. He's got an opening. Simmons a shot and that's sealed up by Fleury. Let's head down to Pierre McGuire for Progressive Inside the Glass.
Thanks a lot, Doc. Physical play, you heard Mike Milbury and Keith Jones talk about it with Liam McHugh. Physical play is going to be a huge part of this series, but in the first period, it was all about Pittsburgh dictating targeted physical play against a Flyer defenseman and then against a star like Claude Giroux. And there's another example of physical play. Take a hit to make a play and then take another hit without retaliating after you score. The Penguins have been much more physical and much more poised after 20 minutes. Supply.
No team had a better record in the Eastern Conference at home than the Penguins. No team had a better record on the road in the entire league than the Flyers. And we talked earlier about how the Flyers have come back from deficits of 2 or 3 goals. But this is a tall order here at the beginning of the second season. Joe Vitale will take the draw opposite Danny Briere.
We've seen that kind of draw before, haven't we, Doc? It led to all kinds of shenanigans a few weeks ago.
That one deflected off a Penguin out of play, so the faceoff remains there.
Pascal Dupuis getting in the lane against Marc-André Baudon.
No hint of any of that so far, Pierre.
No,
right?
No, and I think discipline's a big part of it. Keith and Mike talked about that as well. You've got to be disciplined if you're going to play in the playoffs. And once you lose your discipline, then your game plan falls apart, and then you lose a game pretty quickly, and then you got to rebound pretty quick or you're out of the series.
Two teams play again here on Friday, then Sunday afternoon and Wednesday in Philadelphia. Dupuis shot nicely blocked down. Nudge back on now for Briere. Lots of ice time for him thus far tonight. This one hoisted back out by Vitali. Goes after it with Bordeaux. They cancel and Bordeaux emerges and pushed one that Engelund will have to go back for, but instead he defers to Brooks Orpik.
They're trying to get Orpik off the ice. They want Lovejoy to take his place, but they can't get him off. He's going to get off now, though. Lovejoy's going to go on.
It is the period of the longer change that you have to make defensively. This comes along now for Engelund. Swings it back in deep, and it's centered in front, grabbed off by Max Talbot. And the Flyers are able to push it back out. Talbot stepped into there, trying to fish it loose and hopes for Ronaldo, who moves in and does walk away with it. Ronaldo popped it back in, but already in the zone was another of the Flyers.
There's a different line. Usually Couturier's on the line with Talbot and Ronaldo. Now they're trying Eric Wellwood. So for Peter Laviolette and the Flyers, it's pretty simple. You don't like the way things are going so far. Probably the only line that's manufactured anything. Hartnell, Giroux, and Yager, and they're on the ice right now, and they play right into the last change. George Stahl out there with Kennedy and Cook. That's the matchup Pittsburgh wants, along with Orpik and McCullough. Penalty coming, yeah.
Orpik was stunned by that hit.
Giroux boarding.
And the first call of the game.
And Giroux understands it's going to be a long, grinding series, so he goes after the guy that he plays against all the time, and that's Orpik. So he gets him from behind in a vulnerable position, a dangerous hit. And Doc, I'm convinced if you told the players you'd be allowed to wrap up and take the man into the wall in that situation, we wouldn't have a lot of those boarding calls. Brian Burke, the general manager in Toronto, has been pushing for that for a long period of time. And I really believe if they put that in there, it'd save a lot of bodies in the league.
What you're saying is sort of a legal hold then, Pierre, right?
Pushing the player's blow, just drive him into the wall.
Power play brought to you by Husqvarna. The boarding call on Giroux at 3:04. Walked across by Neal. One-time shot by Malkin is grabbed.
Everything's right about the power play there, except no slot area presence. It's too easy a save for Brizgalov. The puck moves so quickly, Pittsburgh can never get anybody in front. Look how quickly the puck moves from Letang to Neal. Get it out. And breaks everything down. Kunitz pops out, but there's no slot area presence because of the quick puck movement.
Last year in the first round, which was the only round for the Penguins, without Malkin and Crosby, only one power play goal in seven games against Tampa Bay. The end of the year, it was pretty good. Nice reaction there by Brizgalov, or Crosby might have had that alone. So it's held by Fleury. The power play for Pittsburgh ended the year 6 for its last 17. That's fine. Poked along now for Crosby. Canested on back, and it's held for a shot by Neal that's turned aside by Brizgalov.
Made three great saves against James Neal in this game, so great releases by Neal. Nice save by Brizgalov.
Two-a-side battle. Malkin and Neal in there for Pittsburgh. It came on to Malkin, laid it to the back. Crosby there, fakes the drive, finesses it back over. Letang twist. Crosby hurried, and that one blocked down and then cleared along further by the Flyers' defense. Timo Timonen following up on that play defensively as Max Talbot was shut down. Timonen was headed to the bench. Lobs that one in anyway. Roughed up by Crosby, and Pierre almost roughed up for his trouble, too.
That's a big body play by Crosby and Timonen. Nothing wrong with that. Good hard hockey.
Carried back on now by Kunitz and then led across, and here is a block to center, but almost was a play that Couturier would dream about. Flip back on now for the carry on by Jordan Stahl. Dips the shoulder but can't get it by. Rifled back into traffic and settled down. Pushed on by Sullivan, punched further by Cook, and brushed right back out again. 5 minutes have been played. Flyers have two shots this period. Penguins have two. Nice cut of the puck there. Right out of the box comes Giroux. He's got a man around in front. Giroux made it! Oh, and what a save by Fleury on Hartnell! Earlier on Yager, but a Tim Beller this time on Hartnell. Pushed behind by Stahl. Taken to the outside by Kennedy. The chant is Fleury. The shot is by Stahl. Circles and deals it back on. Trouble there for Kennedy.
And it's lobbed all the way back out to center where Hartnell could not finesse. Paul Martin could, and it's brushed back by Stahl. Here's Martin tipping it on as Kennedy. Stahl tried to lob it on through. The depth at center is strong for Pittsburgh. It is Yager ahead. Fed one across, and the stick of Giroux failed him, and that helicoptered over to the boards. Meanwhile, it can be played on now by Orpik. Up the middle in any sport, if you have strength there, you're usually going to be successful. It helps if you have a goaltender. Pittsburgh does. Tipped along now for Asham. Asham starting it on ahead. Could not be handled by Vitale. Pushed on back, and it's a chance around in front for Briere. He scores! Danny Briere! A huge goal for Philadelphia, 3-1.
Talk about being an opportunist. Danny Briere gets knocked over, and he's late getting out of the zone. Look how late he is. He's behind the Pittsburgh Penguin defense. Then a turnover, and Braden Shen, here's Briere yelling, "I'm open, I'm open." Fleury commits down early, and Briere takes advantage. But the Pittsburgh Penguin defenseman didn't track Briere. They thought he was going to go for a line change. He didn't. Instead, he stayed on the ice, and a nice heads-up play by Braden Shen. 3-1, Pittsburgh leads, but what a goal by Briere.
"34 years of age from Gatineau, Quebec. Lives in the town of Haddonfield, New Jersey. An original draft pick of a team called the Phoenix Coyotes, and here he is again, shuffling it along now for Simmons. Dropped it around behind, taken by Briere again. Tried to get it in front, but McCulloch said no. He pumped it on ahead. Shen tried to get there, did, left it behind, and it's sent back on for Crosby to ladle ahead to Dupuis. Gives it back to Crosby, and a 3-on-2. Sent back across, and that one wouldn't work for Sullivan. Might be an on-man rush the other way as it's brought ahead by Simmons. Simmons is shot. It's deflected high and out of play by Letang. Early stages. Second period. Flyers have now scored 3-1.
Watch the puck flowing through the neutral zone. And watch Danny Briere. He is clearly offside by at least a foot. Brooks Orpik and Paul Martin didn't like it, but the opportunist Briere takes advantage. It's a missed call. You just move forward, but it shows you it's a game of inches.
Stoked in front, and that one blocked aside by Brizgalov. Worked along by Kimmo Tiiminen. Punched right on back again. The return for Matt Reed would not go for him, but it comes across to him anyway. Nudges it on out to center, and it is pulled free by Wellwood. Wellwood fed one in front, and breaking up the wing and having a pretty fair chance for his trouble was Carl. Centering pass in front. Oh, what a save by Fleury. That time on Voracek. So the ice is tilting the Flyers' way now.
That penalty kill was huge for the Philadelphia Flyers. They had a great chance against Marc-Andre Fleury, and then the offside goal, which has now given Philadelphia some momentum. Wellwood right out to Voracek. Nice save again by Fleury against Voracek. The depth players for Philadelphia are starting to get some things going and put some duress on Marc-Andre Fleury.
Boy, sometimes it goes that way, Pierre, does it not? Where you have the top line sort of canceling one another, and the big line for Pittsburgh has not scored yet.
And it's also about matchups. I mean, everybody in Pittsburgh is really focused in on trying to shut down Hartnell, Giroux, and Yager. So those guys have to skate through quicksand to try to manufacture chances, whereas there's more ice for some of the other players for the Flyers.
It is Malkin's line against Giroux's right now. Yager takes this one. Tried to step free, could not. It's punched back out again by Malkin. Bashed right back in once again, and it would not go near Fleury. Hit an uneven piece of the board for Glass. Yager wanted to get further, but taken away by Kunitz. Laid too far for Malkin. Banged on to center, and Orpik steered it ahead. Follow-up comes from Nicholas Grossman, and that one deflected on back. Reversed onto McCullough. Off of Neal. Much from the circles on out right now. Now Orpik. Rammed around again for Neal. Could not make the play further. Yager swung it ahead. Giroux could not get any further than McCullough. And McCullough able to hoist it on back out. The probing continues. Attack and resistance. Plopped on across now at a delayed offside, and they will signal this one all the way down.
Now you've got Stahl going up against Breer, Simmons, and Shen. So some different matchups from Danny Biles, Madot.
I wonder what the temptation is when you're up 3-0 and then it becomes 3-1 to make some changes like that. Maybe just a fresh look, huh?
That, I think they're trying to get somebody's attention down here on the bench for Pittsburgh. They want to try to get some energy back in the game.
Sure had it in the first, taken off by that Breer goal. Brad, you mentioned the penalty kill. Good point. Laid back ahead by Lilja, but too far. Goes back down, and England hurries there. And icing is called against Philadelphia.
And Bosmo utilized that icing by coming out with Crosby, Dupree, and Sullivan to get some fresh legs against some tired legs. So again, you get last change and you try to use it to your advantage, and that's what Danny Biles was doing.
Ken Hitchcock, the coach of the St. Louis Blues, often has said after a bad period, he has told his team they're in the league too, and they're going to have a good period once in a while. You can't get all down about it, just respond. So far, Philadelphia has. Onto the back it comes for Dupuis to give on a cross. Letang, and that one was deflected by one of the player's defenders.
Shen did a great job there, Doc, getting in the lane.
Not sure if Letang wanted Crosby or he wanted just a shot on goal. I couldn't tell there.
He wanted Crosby, and Shen did a great job getting a stick in that avenue.
Poked on along now, and Paul Martin cannot stop, taking it center and wanded on a cross in the backhand of Crosby. Steered back ahead for Sullivan, moves back in with Dupuis. Played one off the board, hoping for him. Crosby there, it's his jab back up the board by Bourdon. Pitched on further by Martin and jammed on back off Crosby. Lilja tries the other way, held there by Letang. Let one go, then spiked loose by the Flyers. Oh, and a quick shot on goal out of that strange change that came from Crosby and is stopped by Brizgalo.
Letang did a good job keeping the play alive, and Crosby whips it on goal. And it's what you want to see. Good initiation at the point of attack by Steve Sullivan, being physical, whip it on goal, and then watch Crosby come out of the pile and get a quality chance against Brizgalo. Letang just trying to get into the net, and then Crosby sneaks out of the pile. A little bit of escapability there, and a nice play by Brizgalo.
Flyers able to clear one out as far as center, and it skips on back for England. The Flyers' tendency is to have a lot of power plays for and against. The Penguins' tendency is just the opposite. Very, very few. So if you just base it on that stat, so far it seems like an advantage for Pittsburgh. Drawn ahead now by Malkin, led on a cross, and we're going to get a penalty.
Zach Rinaldo's going to get it for a cross check. Brad Watson caught him. He was jousting with James Neal behind the play.
Just past the halfway point of regulation time. We'll play all night if we need to get a winner, but it's 3-1 Penguins. Time now for Edward Jones FaceTime. Pierre is with Flyers coach Peter Laviolette.
What was your message to the team after the first period?
Well, we're a little bit of deer in the headlights there for 20 minutes, so we seem to dial it in here a little bit better. We got to get skating with the puck. We got to get moving, get some offense going here. Standing around watching too much.
Peter, was there any temptation at all to think about taking Brizgalo off out at 3-0?
No, never crossed my mind. So we all got to get used to this. We're in a loud building here, first game of the playoffs, and I think it's good to get our, you know, get that out of the way and move forward here for the next 20 minutes. So next goal is a real big goal for us right now. We score that next one, we got ourselves a hockey game.
Thanks, Peter.
All right, Pierre.
Power play is brought to you by Husqvarna. Rinaldo, the cross check at 10:06. It is Crosby throwing one in front, and that deflected wide, played on now by Letang, gotten to Malkin. Big gunners out there now. Neal with a bad angle pass that ricocheted off a Flyer defenseman and is held by Brizgalo.
Doc, you don't see Pittsburgh taking as many chances on this power play as they did in their first one in the second period. They were really high risk. Now it's just smart, hard plays, trying to get pucks to the goal. It'll be interesting to see if this first unit overstays its welcome. Been on the ice now for 35 seconds.
In a perfect world, you tried to just divide it 1 minute at a time?
Yeah, maybe a little bit longer, but not much more than that.
Played along by Malkin. Malkin waiting. Has a man in front. One-time shot by Crosby, and that one wouldn't go.
Grossman got in the way there. Good job by Grossman.
He will play an awful lot for these Flyers. Led back ahead. Couturier with it. Tried to filter it across. Carl stacked it back in deep. And Letang is able to lay it back onto Crosby. 50 to go on the power play. He gains and drops to Malkin. One-time shot is booted back out by Brizgalov. The try by Kunitz.
Kunitz is so frustrated coming off. Nice save by Brizgalov, his former teammate in Anaheim and also in Cincinnati in the American Hockey League.
To those of you on CNBC who've been watching the Red Wings and the Predators, Pittsburgh on a power play, they got the first three in the game. They lead in game one against Philadelphia 3-1. Crosby closed off. Letang sent it across. Followed up there and spiked back in again by Braden Coburn to the last 10 of the power play. The guys you mentioned, Pierre, been out for almost all of it. As it dribbles down to the last five, some of them have come off.
Yeah, I think that'll be something that Danny Bosma, Tony Granato, and Todd Reardon, their coaching staff, will address as they go forward in this series.
One shot for the Penguins on that power play. The big pad stopped by Brizgalov. Matched that time was Lilia. Up forced right back ahead for Yager. Gains the zone, delays and trickled one through, but it is read there and played along by Matt Cook. Good crossbody there by Couturier. So it's the Flyers finishing their checks now, as the Penguins did in the first period. 7:25 to go in the second, 3-1 Pittsburgh. The shots in this period, 4 for the Penguins and 5 for the Flyers.
Doc, I looked at the composure of Peter Laviolette when we talked to him. The bottom line is maybe they were deers in the headlight in the first period, but they're not anymore. You can see it. They're really building off of that offside goal by Danny Briere. Take advantage of your opportunities. On the Philadelphia side, it's not their fault. It was a blown call. Take advantage on the Pittsburgh side. Don't panic. But so far, Philadelphia's doing a much better job here in the second period.
Tyler Kennedy on a second and then a third effort to push one that went off of Matt Cook, and back in deep. Can be played now by the Flyers. Peter Laviolette had told us a couple of weeks ago the one thing that the team is able to do, largely because of younger players, is to recoil and refocus and get back into games like this. He said they're capable of being fired up because so many of them are young and so many rookies. Here's a shot that had to be turned aside by Fleury on the drive by Colbert. Poked on back deep. It is Simmons there. Threw one around in front. That deflected away with the goal stick. Held by Fleury. And it's knifed out of play into the Flyers bench area. Time now for our degree for men protecting the crease.
Marc-Andre Fleury is a guy that's definitely defending the crease against Jaromir Jagr there. Wayne Simmons right there from a bad angle. 50 feet out front for Scotty Hartnell. And then that one against Jakub Voracek. Marc-Andre Fleury, stellar.
70th consecutive playoff start for him. The record is held by Marty Brodeur, 170. And that will become 171 in Florida on Friday. Goes back to 1994. This is Voracek, tried to one-time throw it, could not. Centering pass, and it goes all the way back down. So Brizgalov helps it along now to Coburn to the last 6 1/4 of the second period. A steal and a centering pass fails from Malkin, and it's popped on back, and this will be an icing race. And backboard is Martin, but it's canceled out. Good work done there by the Flyers, and this one trickled out in front where it can be played by James Neal.
Real nice job by Matt Reed, the leading rookie goal scorer in the National Hockey League this year. Not only can he score, he can really scoot. Oh, baby, that was a rough change. Offside.
Not by much, but by enough.
Matt Reed out of Bemidji State. He's going to be in a foot race with Paul Martin on the Wendy's Robo Cam. You see Paul Martin at the University of Minnesota. He just loses that race.
300 ex-college hockey players in the NHL this year. That's out of about 900. Wow. Sidney Crosby, a goal and an assist. Chris Letang, 2 assists tonight. Danny Briere, the lone Flyers goal from Braden Schenn. Peter Laviolette with the forecast. We get the next goal, we being the Flyers. We've got a hockey game. Poked back along and cannot be reached by Matt Cook, but is brought back ahead by Kennedy. The turn and the backhander is fought off by Brizgalov. Well, you pointed out early in this period, Pierre, he was a different goaltender than he was in the first. Very aggressively so.
You can see it. He's just much more comfortable in the theater right now.
Been ahead, but off the stick of Yager from Giroux. Yager goes waltzing in. It's taken off by Hartnell. Hartnell got it onto the back. Quick trigger pull, and that one cut off in front. And a good defensive play by Brooks Orpik. Laid back along by Kennedy. Jabbed a little bit by Hartnell. Team's in the midst of a fire wagon change here with 4:50 to go in the second. Off of Sullivan's stick. Played along by Letang. Crisply up to Sullivan. Long pass. They were hoping to get it to Dupuis and did. He's got Crosby in front. And because of a good cancellation there by Coburn, it would not go for him. A drive by Martin, and that ricocheted off Dupuis. Carried back on by Simmons. Tries to force his way in after it and succeeds. Away from Letang. Jostled and worked over pretty effectively down there by Paul Martin. Came back on now for Simmons. Led to the back for a one-time shot by Bordeaux. That was deflected away by Dupuis and carried back out to 3-on-2, maybe a 4-on-2. Dupuis gave it out across, got it back again, and a shot is blocked off by Brizgalov, stashed around behind. Crosby has it there. Looked for Sullivan. Jammed one onto the back. Englund there. Drive, and that one is blocked in front and held back along again by Grossman. Delayed and played on back further. And it can be handled by the Flyers and twisted around behind away from Briere. Pushed by Max Talbot, dumped back up by Letang. Bordeaux dropped it right back in again and stopped again by Fleury. 3.5 to go. Laid back in by Asher. Adams cancels with his man, tries to kick it along. Vitaly was nearby, but Matt Carl was able to play it ahead. No luck. Penguins at the line stood tall. Helped right back in again by Timo Tiemannen and played back off of Orpik. Dealt back up the boards, but held there by Carl. But that one is quickly spiked away. And lugged back on a 2-on-1. Carried back in for the feed over to Adams that came across from Asham and blocked away by Brizgalov.
Sometimes you just outthink yourself. Aaron Asham's got to put that puck on goal, not pass it to Adams.
Right-hand shot coming in the right side, right?
Yeah.
So where do you go?
Just go. Get it on goal. There you go.
It's Malkin bringing it off. Malkin with a backhander that's sealed up by Brizgalov and play again is stopped. 2:30 to go in the second, 3-1 Penguins. Let's look at tonight's Ford update. Third career playoff goal for Danny Briere. Crosby 31st. Dupuis with a goal and an assist. 18 straight games to the end of the regular season and into this that have resulted in a Pascal Dupuis point shot on goal and handled by Brizgalov, tipped en route and held there.
Faceoffs are so important at this time of the year. Ilya Brizgalov makes a save. But it's a good job on a faceoff by Malkin, and then it's set up for the right-handed shooting McCulloch for a one-timer. It bounces before it gets to Brizgalov because McCulloch doesn't get a lot of wood on it. And then you see Grossman coming right into James Neal doing his job, clearing the crease. Philadelphia's got to bear down on these offensive zone faceoffs for Pittsburgh. There's a good job by Giroux winning that one.
Jammed across for the feed along that eludes the reach of Hartnell. Is carried right back on now by Cook. Dropped back for Kennedy. Kennedy dealt it. Stole a shot and it's blocked away by Brizgalov. Penguins starting to warm to the task again here. It's Orpik with it. Brooks Orpik gave it along. Kennedy left it behind. Started out by Giroux and flown where Orpik can just gently knife it down, but it was with a high stick and for that reason play is stopped yet again.
Winning battles a big part of this thing, and through good portions of the second period, Philadelphia's been winning those battles. In that situation, they didn't, and it's a quality chance for Jordan Staal. Top line for Philadelphia's going to get a lot of work. Yager, Giroux, and Hartnell are key components for this team, and they're going to see a lot of that guy, Jordan Staal.
Especially should this go into the third period with them a minus two. It's pushed onto the back and lob shot hopped wide where it can be played by Paul Martin. University of Minnesota product saw this brought on now by Kunitz. laid across to a vacant wing, but it's quickly occupied and brushed back in by Malkin. James Neal around to get it. Double teamed, and then a third flyer can play it up the boards. Malkin couldn't get it, but Paul Martin could. Gave it across. Letang a shot, and that deflected wide off the back of the cage. Fed on to Malkin for a bad angle try that wouldn't go. Bordeaux tries to play it further, cannot.
This is really a tough matchup for Andreas Lilja right now.
You mentioned earlier he and Bordeaux, one of the rookies in the Flyer lineup, have had their hands full with the top line, though the top line has not been able to score yet.
And if you think about it, if they have Carter and Mazzaros, it's not a difficult thing. They got
deflection there and a good glove by Brizgalov.
Well, fortunes of war, as you say, Doc, they just don't have enough bodies in the back end, so if this becomes wrong, look out.
Voracek twisting with it now. Voracek holding through one that was blocked around behind. They went right after it again. Played up the boards and jabbed right back. Jake Voracek slid one in front that was spiked away by Fleury. Played on now by Tiemannin. And helped out in front for Paul Martin to slide it along. Dupuis gave it ahead. Crosby able to march on. Crosby with a big drive! And that one over the glove of Tiemannin and off the glass. Played back ahead to center and carried on now by Wayne Simmonds. Simmonds pulls up through traffic. Flipped one that was deflected up out of play with 25.1 to go in the second period. False start, tossed out is Stahl. What are the linesmen saying to the players in a situation like this before the toss out?
Get your sticks down.
Blocked on back and can be controlled back out again by Cook, who's ridden the boards heavily. Wayne Simmonds popped it ahead right in the path of Brooks Orpik. The last 10. Pretty good hit on Braden Coburn by Adams, and that'll do it. 40 minutes are in the books. One bit of discouraging word at the end of the period. Linesmen move in to part them. 23 shots to 13 Penguins. 10 in that period to 7 for the Flyers.
And it's about accumulating hits over the course of a series. Craig Adams initiates with Braden Schenn strong. Puts Adams right down.
40 minutes played. 3-1 Pittsburgh. After two.
Here are your numbers after two. It's Pittsburgh out shooting. It's Pittsburgh out scoring. Keep in mind, though, Philly led the NHL by winning three games this season after falling behind by three goals. Period number three after this.
Third period about to start. No carryover penalties nor power plays. As the boys at NHL Live were discussing, it's been a light night in penalties. And Mr. Milbury thought there should probably be none at this point. Ronaldo cross-checking, Giroux boarding, both of those in the second period. No penalties in the first. Both of the minors to the Flyers thus far. Pulled back one now by Hartnell, and a shot is trapped and held by Marc-Andre Fleury. Time now for Inside the Glass, and here's Pierre.
Well, we just saw Marc-Andre Fleury with a save, but 10 saves in the second period for Ilya Brizgalov. He's a huge story in this game. He wasn't great in the first period, but man, was he stellar in the second. Good rebound control, aware of tracking all pucks going side to side, and when he needed his defense, they were there. But the biggest thing is steering the puck away from danger. I thought Brizgalov was a massive story in the second period.
That's Capital One Inside the Glass with Pierre. This one won't go down near Brizgalov. Matt Turtle with it. Vanessa's a little pass that can be lobbed back out and worked on by Simmonds for Schenn. Simmonds goes in after this one, ladles it on to Schenn, peels to the outside and drops a little pass on for a try in front that's blocked off by Paul Martin. Rebound is sent all the way back to the point. Hurried shot is kicked aside. Diving play to poke it back out to center. A little surge coming from the team in white and orange. And played past Kennedy and down. Another line change. I'm sure those who got the build-up to this series, Pierre, are wondering, is there a lot of chattering between the benches down there tonight?
Zero, none at all. Just sheer professionalism from both sides.
All business here. Yager could not grab onto that one. Tapped on back by Lilia. Taken by Giroux. Moves up with Hartnell. And that one is blocked off by Malkin and pitched away by Brizgalov. Malkin with it. Finesse's one under shot. Had to be handled by Brizgalov.
He's really in the game, Doc Brizgalov. You can see it so much more aware than in the first period.
Quick save made on Neal there. It's held by Giroux and thrown in front where Fleury angled it back along. You look at some of the plays Marc-Andre Fleury has made with his stick, where shots have not had to come on his goal because of that. Onside play and a shot by Kunitz that ricocheted off Yager, and we're going to get a penalty coming up. The call is interference.
Yager's going to get it. Crosby was beating him up the ice with live legs, and Yager just put a hold on him. And it's an easy call for Brad Watson because it's coming right into his living room. Watch Crosby try to sneak around Yager. He gets his arm up, clamps down. And the penalty to Jaromir Jagr for interference.
Third power play of the game for the Penguins. Crosby on the draw with Reed. Sailed out of play, no penalty.
Faceoff's going to be inside. Timo Tiimonen put it up and out of play, but it went off the glass.
Very important kill for the Flyers here. They were sparked by an earlier penalty kill. Puck came to the back now for Crosby, played on to Malkin. James Neal. But an escape all the way back out, and Crosby will go back.
Philadelphia's doing a nice job pressuring the puck now. They realize the pressure points against this Penguin power play, and they're really closing down on a lot of the outlets.
Carried back on by Malkin. Fed across for the setup by Kunitz. On now for Neal. Save for Brizgalov. Overskated by a pair. But a third comes by and stashes it back out. And that's Couturier, who comes to the bench for a change. Letang nicely able to pull away from one. Fed a pass along, and tripped up on the play was Max Talbot. Meanwhile, at center, it's play. Twisted on across for Kunitz, but he could not slow it down, and Carl makes them go back further. Nearing the halfway point of the third power play. Rattled back on for Crosby, directed back ahead, hoping for Malkin, but it's all the way back down, and Grossman can tap it further. Carl tried to play it, but in the way was Sullivan. Kareen back across for Crosby. Dropped it back to the point. Hustling there was Letang to play it back to him. Crosby led one in front. It went off the stick of Stahl, and it's played further by Sullivan. Sullivan played it away from Stahl and back out. You mentioned earlier that lesson that was probably going to be given by the coaching staff for Pittsburgh seems to have fit in, because the second wave guys are also out there. And Stahl being one of them carries this in. Stahl a shot. That over the glove hand of Brizgalov against the glass. Laid on back to Letang. Letang with a shot that's cut off right in front. And then lost in a shot. Oh, and a great glove save by Brizgalov on Sullivan.
Wendy's RoboCam will show you why this is such a good save by Brizgalov. It's read and react. Wendy's RoboCam will show you. You follow the puck. Now watch Brizgalov come right out. He senses danger. He knows, I better get out and make myself look big. He does, and he snags it out of the air off the stick of Stevie Sullivan.
To the last 19 of this man advantage, another faceoff win, and it's McCulloch with it. Dealing it back along for Stahl to hold and shoot one that is blocked right back. Laid around behind for Kennedy. Given on back now to Stahl. McJordan Stahl tried to play it in front. No luck there. Lilly in the way. Kennedy yet again. Deals off to Stahl, breaks to the net, but it's the outside and a quick trigger pull by Cook. Was off the stick of Brizgalov. Twisting along with it is Kennedy. Tried to play it back, could not. Penalty time is up. Flyers on a 3-on-2. Broken up, though, by a strong play from Paul Martin. Penguins bring it back. Stahl walks it on. Shot one. Off the pipe! Do you believe in omens? Might have been 4-1. What happens now? Shot by Yager. Save! Marc-Andre Fleury comes up strong again.
Second time in the same shift for Jordan Stahl. He tries to go high glove side on Brizgalov. Working on that car. He's going to drive wide, start to push. Goes high glove, and it fools Brizgalov, but the left post saves him.
Had it all the way.
Not even a shot on goal, Patrick Roy would tell you when he's playing in Montreal.
False start on the faceoff and a quick shot into the paraphernalia of Marc-Andre Fleury as a result.
And then Patrick Roy would go and kiss the goalpost on.
Never did have any lack of iron in his system, did he? Played on out now by Adams. Hustling for it to Puig. Good reach and a cancellation by Grossman. And offside is called. Discover Card has given one lucky fan the opportunity to win their own day with the Stanley Cup. Visit discover.com/Stanley Cup to enter. Just another reason why it pays to Discover. Pierre was an assistant coach here in Pittsburgh when they won twice. Did you get the cup for your family?
Uh-huh. I won't tell you what I did with it, though.
Okay. Eddie Olczyk has revealed that a horse ate from the Stanley Cup. Mike Rupp, when he won it in 03 with New Jersey, had a huge bowl of cereal and some ice cream out of it.
Pretty good bench companion, Mark.
Oh, yes, okay. Here's Adams pushing one around and canceled out with Vitaly. So Vitaly around, wanted to get to the front. Good defensive play made on him, though. And then Vitaly is roughed up and shoved a little further by Braden Coburn. Boy, Coburn's played a lot and will play a lot.
Same with this gentleman, Nicholas Grossman.
Briere able to finesse it ahead so it can be brought on by Simmons. Shen went in. Still on the battle to a side. Under 15 to go regulation. Orpik led it across. Game one, best of seven. All games carried by the NBC Universal family. Later on tonight, that means you're going to see Los Angeles and Vancouver. Game one in Vancouver. No pressure. Just the Stanley Cup playoffs. Win the President's Trophy. Still no pressure, right? Headed on back. Brooks Orpik brought it ahead. Neal pushed it in. 14 and a quarter to go as of right now. Much of the play was from the circles on out in the second period. Seems to have evolved a lot that way in the third, but will it continue? Hartnell trickled one in front. Rising backhander was blocked off by Fleury and cleared back out again. Will it be icing? Answer is yes.
Well, we talked about Brizgalov warming to the task. So is Marc-Andre Fleury. He's come up with some stellar saves in this game. It's a real nice job by Giroux getting the puck to Hartnell and then jump your defenseman in. Like you see Andreas Willia do in that situation. Jump in, Hartnell puts the puck, tries to put it on goal, and he does it. And Willia just beats James Neal to the net.
Marc-Andre Fleury. Not a very old guy. Hanging in real well for Pittsburgh tonight. Pittsburgh 3, Philadelphia 1, offensive zone faceoff. Matt Reed will try to win it. Up against Crosby for this draw. Crosby prevailed. Martin drummed it along, but it kept alive. Voracek had it spiked away, kept working. Popped on over to Crosby. Tried to play further. It bounced on for Letang. Tough play for him to make. Overskated, then flicked on back by Voracek. Letang able to scale one back out. Glove down, played on by Dupuis. Let it back over. Crosby trying to finesse by. Mutual bear hug going on there with Grossman. Peeled off by Wellwood. Led on back for the finesse play back in. After it is Reed. Voracek around to get it there. Trying to poke it free is Dupuis. Dupuis with a couple of points in this game tonight. Crosby able to pump it across. He's got a couple as well. Controlled back out again by Letang and led on to Dupuis and stashed back in again. There have been predictions of blood. Well, it's a long series. Might still happen, but right now it's the clock that's bleeding down and it's gone under 13 minutes. 12:53 left in the third. Played along by Orpik and chopped back out again. The probing continues to get that important goal. Hooked through one in front. One turning was Brizgalov, but it caromed crazily at him. Carried back on now by Briere, and he holds. Delays through traffic. Briere flung one that was off the stick of Stahl and wide. Stahl goes to work there on Simmons. Two big guys. Finessed on by Carl. Knocked loose by Lovejoy. Poked on back to center and settled down by Tiemann. 12 and a quarter to go. Offside. And this time it's called.
Doc, fans are giving a little bronze cheer to the officials for that offside on Danny Briere. But, you know, the big thing in this one right now is you can just see Pittsburgh starting to settle into more of a defensive posture, and Philadelphia starting to jump their defense and to try to manufacture some offense.
Might be a little early for Pittsburgh to be shutting it down.
How do they telegraph that, Pierre? How do you size that up and see it right?
Not nearly as aggressive on the forecheck, not jumping their defense in as much, talking about Pittsburgh, not trying to push the pace.
Ooh, that one ricocheted off Brizgalov. Kicked on back to center, lobbed back in again, trying to burrow his way by, but no luck, Malkin.
Now you see much more aggression, so the coaching staff really got to the players. Be aggressive, let's go.
Well, it turned over, did it not, to Neal, who threw one through the crease wide, and now Malkin back. Lobbed around behind, taken by Malkin. Malkin spins and has one that is stopped by Brizgalov at the outside of the cage, and he holds on.
And during that last sequence, Danny Bylsma was on the Penguins bench, and he's saying, good pressure, but make sure our third forward is back. So he's telling guys all the time, he's very actively coaching on the bench, making sure the players on the bench sitting in front of him know. It's great to have three guys in the attack, but make sure you have a third guy high.
Former Los Angeles King player, who was once on a line with a gentleman who is also working here tonight, here, Pierre, Ray Ferraro, and Eddie Olczyk, who will join us on the weekend for NBC coverage in both Boston and Philadelphia. Turn around here by Giroux, and that one shut off. Giroux sees this one come back out in front of Jágr. Can't convert. Bouncing puck is eventually spiked back to center. And the Flyers nearly got that goal that their coach Peter Laviolette was talking about. Skim back in again and can be played by McCulloch. Pushed it back up the defensive boards. It's hacked along by Stahl. Right after it is Jágr. Jágr fed one on to Giroux. On back to Carl. Oh, and what a save made by Fleury.
There's the activated defenseman, Matt Carl, and Pittsburgh loses him in transition. It's a great job by Jágr working on Brooks Orpik, and then the creativity of Claude Giroux gets him right out front to Matt Carl. Nice shot, better save.
Tom Barrasso is here for two cups. And making the large save on Nick Lidstrom of Detroit with a second and a half to go in a game seven. Marc-Andre Fleury authored one. This one is tapped up high and out of play. Another scramble around him and a little tap of thanks to Chris Letang.
Pittsburgh's coaches aren't going to be happy about this. Letang gets hit by Wayne Simmons, turns the puck over, eat it, and then Simmons creates a good opportunity for himself, and eventually Shen's going to be there as well. But Pittsburgh's got to manage the puck a lot better. Again, don't sit back as much.
One shift plowed in pretty well, you were noticing.
Yeah, we're
going to drop back.
Yep.
Played along by Briere, shot, score!
I give Philadelphia a lot of credit, especially this line. Situation where they wanted the puck more. You could see it off the faceoff in the offensive zone, and they started to make things happen. The faceoff's won, but look at the pursuit. Danny Briere, great job battling. Shen, good job being strong in the puck against Martin. Then Briere just going to walk out. I think this goes off of Crosby and by Marc-Andre Fleury. I think it touches Crosby on its way to the net. Briere rotates out of the corner, and it does change direction as it goes past Marc-Andre Fleury. That's a great job by the Flyers. They lose the draw. They know where to go. They recoil the puck and put it on goal. Two goals in this game for Briere.
And to quote his coach, now we have a hockey game. 10:40 to go in the third. Some restlessness in the stands here. 18,387. They couldn't put in any more seats. Same in Philadelphia when we moved there. Dropped on back for the play along to Vitali. Vitaly along the board, saw a jab loose by Coburn. Adams goes to work as well. Pulled free by Matt Reed. The rookie gives it back on, and it is started back out by Giroux. Giroux fed it on across, and here's a combination in front that spiked up high, driving to the net was Coburn. Taken now by Adams. Pulls free and twists away from the check that was coming from Giroux. Angled back in where it is Brizgalov to take it. And now the saves that Brizgalov made in the second period are looking much larger.
And now you're seeing a lot more ice time for Giroux and Danny Briere.
This is McCollum. The guys that get it going and trigger the response are the ones that get there. And remember, the Flyers have come from deficits often in this season. Laid back on for Briere, trying for the natural. A backhander is steered away.
Sit back. Philadelphia's taking advantage of sit back.
And now Pittsburgh's going to be penalized.
Interference is the call. The first power play of the night for the Flyers. Up by a man, down by a goal. Midway third period in Pittsburgh.
Danny Briere working on Zabinek McCulloch. He puts the puck on goal. It goes up in the air. Watch Brooks Orpech. Never gives Briere a chance to make the play. They call for interference. Orpech to the penalty box. First power play of the night for Philadelphia. Key juncture of the game, Doc.
Hartnell comes in as Giroux is chased out. Simmons is the other forward up front. Voracek and Tiemannin in back. Tiemannin slipped it across. Voracek holds it there and stashes it back in. Off of Hartnell, but he regrabs. Tried to play the point, but it's carried back up by Staal shorthanded. Moving up with Matt Cook. Staal to the outside, gets an opening. Bennett to Cook, and a shot! And that one wouldn't go.
What awareness by Staal. He knew Voracek was a four, and he worked him hard. Took him right to the net.
Pushed on across now, and Tiemannin gains the zone. Tried to play it along, could not. Turned around as Giroux. Worked on there by Cook. Played back further for Giroux. Jab back in deep away from Paul Martin. Waiting for it, Jake Voracek. Twisted it on back down to Simmons. Hands it on to Giroux. Led to the back, Tiemannin. As Voracek across, gives to him. Fed on back now for Giroux. Giroux drifting further. Little handcuff of a pass, but Tiemannin a nice redirect. Voracek just holding to the outside. As Simmons inside the box. Good stop by Giroux. Pulls, fires, and that one blocked in front. And it is cleared, but not out. What a great diving keep there was made by Giroux. Jab back to the half boards, and he's right there to get it. Puck went on further. Simmons had it knifed away. Teaming into the back with it. Fires, and that one blocked wide.
McCulloch again with another block. Cook was out of gas.
Two in a row for McCulloch.
They just got Pascal Dupuis on the ice. Some wide legs now for the Penguins. Full change.
Hartnell pulls it away. 25 to go on his team's power play as they probe for the tying goal. Yager able to glide in. Passes back on to Hartnell. Fires, and then deflected. Score! A tie game! Shen! 7:37 to go in the third.
Doc, what a play by Jaromir Jagr to gain the zone, and then the awareness of Scotty Hartnell to get this puck on goal to the breaking Braden Shen. Jaromir Jagr is going to take the feed. Patience, break it down. He knows Shen, that is Hartnell. No, Shen's going to the net. Look at the stick on the ice and a little chip deflection by Marc-Andre Fleury. Look at Hartnell's head. He's looking right at the target for Shen driving to the net. What a finish and what a play by Scotty Hartnell.
Flyers led the league in power play goals during the regular season. They have connected on their first opportunity of the night and have tied the game. Shen with a goal and two assists. Every game is a battle of wills. Whose will be stronger here? 7 minutes and 20 seconds to go in regulation.
This is about what we thought would happen in this series, though, isn't it, Todd? Evenly played, hard and in your face, but good composure from both teams.
Moving in to take his own pass, one-handed behind by Talbot. A little jam play at the front will not work for Wellwood. Stepping to this now is Kunin. Bounced on to center and turned back haphazardly. Can be canceled on a cross by the Penguins' defense. And eventually re-grabbed and thrown back to center. Finesse move by Malkin, and then it's spiked back in by the Russian-born centerman. This is held around behind by Lilja, and Lilja can play it across. Matt Carl able to bank it out there. Spun back on by Couturier. Offside is called, and then the trigger pulled afterwards, and so there'll be some chatting that will occur there. Shen, Hartnell, and Yager get scoring points on Shen's first goal in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
That was vintage Jaromir Jagr. That reminded me of Jaromir Jagr in 91 and 92 when he was 18 and 19 years old. Gaining the line, making a smart piece of distribution of the puck, and then obviously the great finish by Shen off the awesome feed by Hartnell.
Brizgalov sets it up. Penguins with four shots on goal in this period. Flyers have nine. Icing will bring an offensive zone faceoff for Pittsburgh near Brizgalov with 6:27 left. Have benches been shortened, do you notice, Pierre?
A little bit. They're trying to get Drew and Breer out as much as they can. For the Philadelphia side, Couturier's kind of taking a little bit of a sidestep. Matt Reed's taking a little bit of a sidestep. And Braden Shen's so effective. You see him take that faceoff right there instead of Breer, and he wins it clean.
Paul Martin ahead. Pat back in by Sullivan. Twisted along low, and Crosby right in the path of that, and twirled a pass in front, but it was right on a flyer stick.
Change on the fly. They're trying to get the big line again for Philadelphia. Hartnell, Yager, and Giroux on the ice. Here comes Giroux.
Off of Paul Martin. Carried back out by Letang. Got it on to Dupuis. Bounced back in off the half boards. Corralled there by Coburn, and he's checked off enough by Sullivan that he had to make a pass that was a little bit dangerous, but handled well by Carl, and eventually back to Corfin. In the midst of a change, the Flyers. Everything legal down there as we get down to the last 5:35 of the third period. Three goals by the Penguins in the first, and the Flyers kept chipping back. Breer with one in the second, another in the third, and then Shen tied it on the power play. McCullough starting back ahead again for the Penguins. Knocked down by Giroux was that pass. And so it is Orford. Fanned on a circle-to-circle. Looks ahead this time. Wanted to thread one on, and it ricocheted all the way back in on Brizgalov, who can set it up now for Timonen. Voracek turned around, dodged the check, and now it's led back on, and Couturier moving in. Jammed one that's fought off by Fleury. Taken to the outside again by Carl. Carl saw that one squib loose, and it's Cook handing on to Kennedy. Kennedy marches back in, delays now with a man breaking to the net. It was Stahl. Stahl bumped off behind but has possession. Cannot get it, though, for Lovejoy. Nice pull there by Couturier. Laid it back out now for Voracek, and Voracek gently taps it back in. Comes to the bench for a change. 4:35 to go here in the third. Sliding ahead with it is Malkin. Leading scorer in the league. Hands it on across, and the flip back went off him on the return pass from Neal. Then it's grubbed on back to center where McCulloch has it. Led back on, and again it's James Neal. Got one back. Kunitz a shot, and that's stopped and covered by Brizgalov. 4:14 to go. Third period, 3-3. A bumpy ride to the finish. Let's take a look at tonight's Lexus Competitive Edge. Two goals for Danny Briere, 1-1 for Sidney Crosby. Both important factors in a game that is tied with 4:14 to go in the third. Malkin chased out of the faceoff. Kunitz to take it with Couturier, who won it through. Peter Laviolette was saying this morning, from the opening night of the season in Boston, Couturier was out with a one-goal lead in the last minute. First game in the NHL, and he's played in all the important ways that a player can play, not just a rookie. And he said if it's a critical time tonight, he's going to be out there again. And he, 14 in the white uniform, just pushed that one across. That's dealt back in. Letang trying to play it there. Then Paul Martin, then back up to Chris Kunitz. Kunitz for the Penguins got it as far as center, and it's laid on back now for Timonen.
Instead of having Zach Rinaldo on that line with Couturier and Talbot, it's Matt Reed on the ice playing the wing rather than center.
Simmons tried to poke it through, could not. Thrown back out by McCollum. Flip back in again by Matt Cook. 3:20 to go. Lobbed on by Carl, taken by Simmons. Moved back out with Couturier. Now he comes to the bench. Shen remains out. McCulloch yet again. Maybe the puck has just come to him, or he has played an awful lot tonight, McCulloch. Here's Kennedy with a shot that's deflected wide. Chopped on by Carl, who made the initial block. Worked on to Simmons. Cannot get out with it, but Briere is able to pop it to him. Simmons trying to finesse further. Cannot. Stahl able to step ahead with it and lob one back in. 2:45 to go. Jaromir Jagr, bridge from the bench. Gets to center, lobbed it on across. On the money for Briere. Briere holds to the outside. Briere sent it up. Hurry shot! That ricocheted off the glove of Fleury, and it came from Colbert. Jagr reaches in for that one, can't get it, but Briere had it for a moment before Letang could swing it along. Booted right back by Grossman. Pinballed on around for Crosby to twirl it back down the ice. Trying to get there is Sullivan. Grossman moves in, slammed by Sullivan. Puck winds up underneath, and Hartnell is there. Then Crosby, knife loose. Crosby threw one in front, and that directed just wide. Dupuis chopped it back on. 2:05 to go. In front, flexing it. That one brings Golov as Crosby was hoping to poke it home. Lifted back out by Lilia. Just coming to the bench was Briere. Ladled back in by Crosby, who comes to the bench for a change, and a fire wagon change there by the Penguins. It is Kunitz moving on, shooting one, and that blocked wide. Kunitz able to hold in all the traffic. Got it on to Malkin. Malkin around behind. That one is banked off Chris Golov and back down by James Neal. Fleury with a careful tap back out. 90 to go in regulation as of now. Brizgalov sets it up there, and it's Carl dropping it back on for Timonen. Crossbody put on him by Kunitz. Poked on back, and again McCulloch spirited it back out. Kunitz trying to reach that one. Spiked on back now for Orpik, and Kunitz slams it back in. Again, Brizgalov slows it down. Holds and then threw one back up the board that almost wound up on the stick of Malkin, but ahead Couturier, and his stick fails him on the block by McCulloch. Patted back into some traffic by Fleury, but now able to gallop ahead with it, lead it on as Neal. Neal with a shot. That one ricocheted back out. Is geared on back down the ice. Will it go for an icing? No, it has to be played before by Letang. 50 to go. Reversed back along and dragged down for his trouble was Giroux. It is Stahl leading it ahead. Kennedy got it there, could not return it. Again, back in. Fleury handed it over. Letang up the boards. Cut off by Jagr and thrown in front. Had to be blocked by Fleury. Letang starting it ahead now. 28 to go. Jammed one on to Cook. Deflected it back in. Coming across to get it is Colbert. Reverse back up the board. Can be played by Carl. Twisted on further to Simmons. Floated it out away from the reach of Sullivan to center. Chopped at there and then fed back on near Briere. Thrown back out by Orpik with 10 to go in regulation time. This is McCulloch turning it behind for Paul Martin. It can take all night. We will at least start that way. It will be one overtime. At least. 52 shots, 28 by Pittsburgh. Six goals divided in half. We've played 60. Gonna take more. It was all Pittsburgh in the first period. They outshot the Flyers 13-6 and led 3-0. But back came the Flyers chipping away. Briere offside, but it counts. Briere again, and then Shen to tie it. Jaromir Jagr has scored 4 of these in overtime. Danny Briere, 3 overtime winning goals. Claude Giroux, 1. Dupuis, Letang, Malkin, and Neal, 1 each.
Doc, you got to be so aware here to start overtime. Long change. Players are getting tired. Fatigue becomes part of it. Mental mistakes.
And you discovered there is an absence for the Flyers.
Marc-Andre Bourdon done for the night. Upper body injury. We were talking about that could potentially be an Achilles heel for the Flyers. Pittsburgh continue to go after their defense and punish them. And clearly the punishing kicked in here in game one.
Andre Mazaros has missed the last 6 from the Flyers' defense. Make that 7 if you count this one tonight. Brizgalov 1-1 in overtime. 7-2 is Marc-Andre Fleury. And that one is right in on him. And the rebound! Oh, and Fleury dove across. as the shot went wide from Hartnell. Carried back on by the Penguins, and it's Kennedy. But offside is called.
Rolling puck. In a lot of different situations, and Hartnell gets an opportunity. Look at the puck rolling around. Kennedy tries to make a play on it. He can't. And another rolling puck, and Hartnell just can't get to it, and Fleury's there. And he knows. Doesn't take long, Doc, in overtime sometimes. Just keep getting pucks on goal. Both teams will be doing that.
Overtime, unlike regular season, is not 5 minutes. It is not four against four. It's playing regular hockey. All the way to the end, no shootout. Dealt along by Martin, played along by Letang. Knocked down by Dupuis, gathered in, and twisted along by Briere, but an offside pass. 40 seconds into the first overtime period.
April Fool's Day seems like a long time ago. 11 days ago. And all of the finger pointing, stick swinging and screaming. And those were just the coaches. But a very well played game here, battling back the Flyers. Very few penalties. Four minors, three to Philadelphia, one to Pittsburgh. And that one was costly. That was the tying goal. Letang fed it ahead. Dupuis has Crosby nearby, but offside is called, and then Dupuis was rubbed out.
Braden Schenn's had a tremendous game here. Scoring the tying goal, being physical, taking faceoffs, really fitting in well with Danny Briere and Wayne Simmonds. Tremendous night for young Braden Schenn. First playoff game.
The first one for a dozen of the players out of 40 that suited up tonight.
Here's another one, Sean Couturier. He's had another good night playing in a matchup situation against Evgeny Malkin and James Neal. Now they have Eric Wellwood on this line with Talbot instead of Zach Rinaldo.
Fleury stops it behind and hurries it off the glass. Chip back up the boards and fed out by Malkin. A race on and Neal there, but also Wellwood to take it away. Couturier flipped it across. Spike back in deep by Kunitz, but offside. Very close, but a neutralized faceoff to result here.
And I think there's a whole lot of sensitivity about offsides now for both linesmen, Brian Murphy and Tony Cericolo, after what happened on the Briere goal. Kunitz tries to keep this alive, rolling. Yeah, it comes outside. Eagle eye there. They didn't like it on the Penguins bench.
They were closest to it, but like the fans, they can see with their hearts and not their eyes. Pushed on for Reed. Outreached by Martin. That one flipped behind. Reed with it there. The jam play at the side of the net by Voracek would not go. Just now getting back to his feet. The guy who saved that day, Marc-Andre Fleury. So it is teaming in to get it. At one time when it was 3-1, big chance for the Penguins, they hit the goal post. Back came the Flyers to tie it. We are in the overtime period that has resulted. It is Giroux to get it there. Dropped it back on. Reed shoved it around behind. Voracek walled there, but gets back up to play. Taken to the outside, a twisted one in front that's jabbed away by the alert Fleury and goal. Another try in front. Oh, it's deflected. They score! Voracek! And the Flyers have come from 3-0 down to win game one in overtime.
Philadelphia just started winning races, Doc, and you can see it was a carryover into the third period and then into overtime. Winning races, Voracek keeps the play alive against Stahl. Stay hard on it. Spinning shot. Can't get to that puck. Kennedy can't get it on goal. Can't get to that puck. Stahl can't get to it. Voracek can't. And Philadelphia comes in here and wins game one after being down 3-0.
They have played seven times in Consol Energy Center. And these Flyers have won six of those, including this first one in the Stanley Cup playoffs. It came at 2:23 elapsed time in the first sudden death overtime period. 28 shots to 26. Pittsburgh 4-3. Flyers. Jake Voracek with Pierre.
Thanks a lot, Doc. What'd your coach tell you during the timeout when you were down early in the game?
Well, he said that, the cost comeback is for nothing. And we played well since second period. And, we were struggling all year with the beginning of the games. And we get back and we get a win again, so that's great.
What was the feeling when you were down 3-0 and it looked like Ilya Ryzhagov was really struggling? How'd you guys get it back?
Well, you know what? We were keeping it with the plan, staying with the plan, and put a lot of sparks at the net, and, we turned around, which is great.
Jaromir Jagr, obviously a veteran presence from your same hometown. Did he say anything to the team during the game?
Well, he's a great leader, he's been in those situations so many times, and he just said we got to stay calm, and play the same way like we did all year long, and it will be fine, and that's exactly what we did.
Thanks for your time, and keep having fun in this series.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Doc? Jake Voracek scored the winning goal in OT. The final 4-3 Flyers. The Stanley Cup playoffs presented by GEICO.